5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। लेट अस नाउ एग्जामाइन वेदर अ कॉन्ट्रैक्टर इंगेज्ड टू एग्जीक्यूट अ पर्टिकुलर वर्क कैन फाइल अ सूट फॉर अकाउंट्स अगेंस्ट द एम्प्लॉयर इन रिगार्ड टू पेमेंट फॉर द वर्क डन। सच अ राइट इज नॉट क्रिएटेड आर रिकॉग्नाइज्ड बाय एनी स्टैट्यूट। द इंडिपेंडेंट कॉन्ट्रैक्टर इज नॉट एन एजेंट ऑफ द एम्प्लॉयर, nor is the employer in the position of a trustee with reference to the independent contractor. Can the claim be supported in equity by stating that where the relationship is such that rendition of accounts is the only relief while will enable the contractor to satisfactorily assert this legal right. A contractor who is engaged to execute a work is expected to maintain his own accounts. At all events, there is no bar for a contractor to keep an account of the work done. Even where the contract between the employer and independent contractor may provide for payment on the basis of measurements to be recorded by the employer, nothing prevents the contractor from measuring the work done by him and then suing for the value of the work done. The contractor may also demand joint measurements to determine the quantum of work done. If the employer for some reason does not cooperate or prevents the contractor from taking up physical measurements, the contractor can seek appropriate legal remedy which will enable him to take measurements or to secure the information from the measurement book in the custody of the employer. Therefore, either the fact that the measurement book is maintained by the employer or the fact that the contractor does not possess the exact measurements will not entitle the contractor to file a suit for rendition of accounts against the employer. A careful reading of Section 149 shows that it would apply only in respect of the court fee payable at the time of institution of the suit. If the court fee due to on the plaint when instituted is not paid wholly or partly by the person instituting the suit, the court in its discretion may allow him to pay the court fee or deficit court fee within the period fixed by it. Section 149 has no application where the court fee due on the plaint as per the valuation of the suit is fully paid, but subsequently it is found that a larger amount is due to the plaintiff. For example, if the plaintiff values the suit at rupees 2 lakhs and the court fee payable is rupees 20,000 and the plaintiff pays a court fee of rupees 10,000 on his request, time for payment of balance of rupees 10,000 can be extended by the court at its discretion under section 149 CPC. But where the claim was rupees 2 lakhs and full court fee of rupees 2 lakhs was paid at the time of institution of the suit, the question of permitting the plaintiff to pay deficit court fee at that stage does not arise, as no court fee becomes payable at that stage.